Today we are going to learn about place values. Place values are so awesome because they help you decode numbers so you can find out how much numbers are worth. So if you're ready, let's get started with learning about place values. First, we want to teach you a fun word, okay? We're going to teach you a brand new word. Maybe it's brand new to you. Maybe you've heard it before. But yes, you are right now going to learn a new word. That word is digit. Yeah, digit. Can you say that? Yeah, let's say it together. Digit. What a fun word. What does the word digit mean? Is Digit your neighbor's dog that looks really cute but is always in a bad mood? Hey, Digit, I'm just trying to pet you. Give you a little bit of a treat if you would be a little bit more nice. Okay. Well, it is a good name for a dog, but that's not what we're talking about when we say Digit. So, what are digits? Digits are the parts of a number. Like, look at the number 920. There are three parts, or digits, in this number. The number 920 has three digits. Remember, digits are the parts of a number. Pretty simple. Let's look at the number 74. There are two parts, or digits, in the number 74. The number 74 has two digits. Remember, digits are the parts of a number. Super simple, super easy. And finally, let's look at the number 6. How many digits are in the number 6? Remember, we're just looking at the parts of the number. How many digits? Yeah, just one digit. There's only one part or digit to this number. It's just 6. Great job. Remember, digits are the parts of a number. Okay, so this is awesome. Here is where place values come in. The place value is how much a digit is worth based on where it is. In other words, where a digit is in the number tells us how much it is worth. So, what are the place values we're going to be looking at today? What are the different values of the places where the digits will be? Well, the digits will either be in the ones spot, the tens spot, the hundreds spot, or the thousands spot. Alright, let's use the place values. Okay, so here are the place values and where they are for the different digits. This first spot is the ones spot. That's where the ones go. This second spot is the tens spot. It's where the tens go. This third spot is the hundred spot. It is where the hundreds go. And finally, here is the thousands spot. It is where the thousands go. Now, the place values can go higher than this, but these are the only place values we're going to be learning about today. All right, so our first example is the number 4,000. The number 4,000. All right, well, I'm going to need your help. Which digit is in the ones spot? You can see it right there. Which digit is in the ones spot? Yeah, 0. Great job. All right, how about helping us figure out the tens? Which digit is in the tens spot? Yeah, 0. Good job. All you have to do is look where the arrow is pointing. The 10 spot is a 0. All right, how about the hundreds spot? Which digit is in the hundreds spot? You see? Yeah, the same answer, zero. Good job, good job. Okay, and which digit is in the thousands spot? Which digit is in the thousands spot? Yeah, four. Awesome. The number four is in the thousands spot. There are four thousands in the number 4,000. All right, our next example is the number 508. Okay, I'm going to need your help again. Which digit is in the ones spot? You can look at the place values for a clue. You could see the arrow. Which digit is in the ones spot? Yeah, 8. Good job. Okay, which digit is in the tens spot? Which digit is in the tens spot? Yeah, 0. Good job. All right, which digit is in the hundreds spot? Can you see that? Which number is in the hundreds spot? Yeah, 5. Good job. Okay, now this might seem a little tricky. Which digit is in the thousand spot? Which digit is in the thousand spot? Wait a second, there isn't even a digit there. It's only 508. There are no thousands. So the digit would be nothing or zero. Zero and nothing, it has the same value. So there's nothing that's in the thousands spot. It's only 508. There are no thousands. You are doing a phenomenal job. Okay, now you're going to be able to give it a try without any help or any clues. And you've learned so much. I think you can do it. I think you can do it. You're going to do awesome. Okay, you're ready. Here's the number, 8,763. 8,763. We're going to name the place values, and you let us know which digit is in which one. Okay, which digit is in the one spot? Which digit is in the one spot? The number is 8,763. Which one? Yeah, 3. 3 is in the one spot. Remember, this is the one spot. Good job. Okay, what's in the 10 spot? Which digit is in the 10 spot? 6. 6 is in the 10 spot. Good job. Yeah, you can see right here is where the 10 spot is. Wow, you're getting the hang of it. Okay, which digit is in the 100 spot? Do you know which one? Which digit is in the 100 spot? 7. Way to go. Yes, 7 is in the 100 spot. And you can see right here is that 100 spot. 7 is in the 100 spot. Good job. Okay, here's the last one. Which digit is in the 1,000 spot? Which digit is in the 1,000s spot? 8. Yes, good job. 8 is in the 1,000s spot. And you can see right here is where that thousands spot is, just before that comma. Isn't that awesome? Wow, you've learned so much. To review, digits are the parts of a number. The place value is how much a digit is worth based on where it is. These are the place values we learned today, the ones, tens, hundreds, and thousands. In this example, there are 3 ones, there are 6 tens, which is 60, there are 7 hundreds, which is 700, And there's eight thousands. So the number read out is 8,763. It's so nice going for a stroll and just thinking about those place values. Oh, I love the ones and the tens and the hundreds and the thousands. Knowing where a digit is tells us what the value is, which is great. So we hope you learned some cool things, and we hope to see you next time.